guys, so I am coming to you today with a marker review. I know you guys are excited about that. My marker reviews tend to be the heavy hitters of this channel. And I was contacted by Jonah of Pin Art to see if I would be interested in reviewing their markers. Now, this isn't a paid for review, but they did send me the markers for free for the purposes of this review. So, you know, full disclaimer, that should not affect my opinion other than I didn't pay for them out of pocket. So if they're not very good, I'm not gonna be super angry about having, you know, lost some money on that. So you get, or one gets, or I received 12 markers. These are distributed by MCC Global Trading, and that is in Buffalo, Wyoming. And this is pretty much the only marking on these. And these were sent to me when I was in Luling, Louisiana, but due to various external circumstances, this is the first chance I've gotten to look at them. So I didn't uncap them until now. That's the first time I have ever opened them. And that typing in the background is me pulling up how much these puppies are gonna cost, except I'm not seeing them. Now, I know they were sent from Amazon because that was the information that was on the package. But because they were sent to me directly from Pin Art, I do not happen to have the order in my history. And so I'm going to have to dig around to find a price for these. But I will do that at a later time, I guess, because I feel bad stalling for y'all. And looking up pin-art markers isn't bringing up anything at all. So 12 markers: cobalt blue, vivid green, natural oak, cerulean blue, viridian, carmine, azalea purple, orange, yellow ochre, black, deep violet, and lemon yellow. And these look really similar in body to the they were some markers I got from AliExpress. I want to say they are, I can see it in my head. Shinhan, not touch, but Touo, T-O-U-O-H, with the second O trying to look like a C. These are using a very similar body to those, and I'll see if I can dig those up for you guys in a couple minutes. So these are twin tip markers. We've got a chisel tip on one end. They do smell fragrantly of alcohol marker, and a bullet nib on the other, which tends to be my absolute least fave combination when it comes to markers. And I know some of you guys actually really enjoyed that combination. Let me zoom in so you guys can see that. But it is not a favorite of mine. And the body is pretty plain except for the Pin Art logo on the front. So I'm gonna go grab some paper and some other markers for comparison, and we will get to work. All right, guys, I have assembled a collection of markers as well as my trusty Strathmore mixed media paper that I like to use for these marker tests. I have loads of other swatch tests and field tests in here just to show you guys. So that's also what we're going to be doing. But first, we're going to do a comparative look at the Pin Art marker. So I will go ahead, uncap it. Unfortunately, in order to have it up, I can't have the chisel fully visible, but I will do a twist turn in a minute. And if you feel like you've missed something, you can head on over to natosoup.blogspot.com for the rest of this review. So we've got Pin Art, that Shanghai 2O we were talking about, the Sketchbox signature marker, the only one I have. I can't seem to get a hold of them from other people for love or money. A Spectrum Noir G1 marker, a Prismacolor marker with the brush tip. A Shinhan Twin Touch double-ended marker. Oh, okay, that's the way it's gonna have to go. A Blick Studio marker, and I know you guys have heard me talk about these many a time. A brush tip Sharpie. shoot. That's what happens when you're a Butterfingers like I am. A Copic Chow. Which is a little dirty because it sees a lot of use. A Copic Sketch, which has apparently been overfilled or recently filled because it is very leaky. I didn't even know I had the refill for that color. And finally, a Copic Original that has the optional brush tip inserted. So that should be a pretty good comparison of several different alcohol markers to give you guys an idea. As you guys can tell, I do prefer the brush tips to the bullet tips. So here we have the mixed media paper, and I'm just going to go ahead and swatch all 12 of my markers, and I'll do that in time lapse. So, like the Shanghao Tuo and the Sketchbox Signature, the Spectrum Noir and the Copic Original, the Pin Art marker has a square barrel, which helps prevent it from rolling off the desk too easily, but it may be hard for people with smaller hands like myself to comfortably use. The bullet nib is pretty comparable to the Shanghai Tuo and to the Sketchbox. It looks like they're all using the same mold. And here is the Copic Original for comparison. So they're all pretty similar, pretty standard. Now, the 12 pack of the Pin Art markers is currently $12.99 on Amazon Prime. So it is one of the more affordable ones. You're basically paying a dollar and some change per marker, which is one of the lowest prices you're gonna find outside of AliExpress. But how do they actually stack up? I'm gonna finish capping all these markers and get them stowed away, and we'll find out. All right, so as I swatched each marker, I tried to pay attention to the color that's given on the top of each and to see if that sort of led to an understanding of the color families. And unfortunately, I can't necessarily say that is the case. It does seem that every distinct color has its own color family. It looks like the yellows are in the threes, the oranges are in the twos, the greens do have a discrepancy because you have 8 and you have 4, and 81, let me double check this actually. Okay, so that's 54, I mislabeled that. Okay, so you have, it's still a discrepancy as you have 54 and 46. The purples or the purplish colors seem to be in the 80s. The reds seem to start with 1, the blue-greens seem to start with 6, the blues seem to start with 7. Something else that seems like perhaps a bit of a discrepancy is the brown, which is natural oak, and the yellow ochre are both, when you look at the colors in the markers, they both are brown tones, but you have 101 and 91. So I would be really interested in seeing maybe a color chart explaining these. And I will link you guys both to the Amazon listing and to the site, which is Origini.biz/products/pin art twin tip drawing marker. I'll link you guys to that. And that website lists these as $20.99, which, and it says that these, it's a set of 12 colors, alcohol-based, lighter odor, so they're not going to smell as strongly, double tip, long-lasting ink, and unique grip. And considering I just showed you guys three other very inexpensive plus the Copic Original marker bodies with this sort of a body, I can't really say it is a unique grip. And as someone who has used alcohol markers for several years now, for me, I do have really little hands. This sort of a grip is uncomfortable for me. As for long lasting, alcohol inks are not archival. So you might get a lot of ink out of this barrel. I don't know. I haven't used them enough to know that. But the fact that it is made with an alcohol ink will mean that it's not going to be as light fast. So we are going to do the field test. So I will see you guys in a bit. Hey guys, so today we are putting those pen art alcohol markers to the test. I've already sketched out this really cute little salamander that I feel will sort of put the colors that I have in this sort of limited and bright collection of colors, will sort of put them to the test. And hopefully we can get a good idea of whether or not the pen art markers are worth your money. Now, since they did not come with a blender, I am supplying my own, a Blick Studio blender. And I've also got a Prismacolor blender sort of in reserve. So I'm gonna go ahead and get started. Most of this field test will be in time lapse, but if I need to make a comment, if something is absolutely vital, I will do so. So I hope you guys enjoy and keep watching until the end where I will give you my verdict on the pen art markers.
Thank you.
Okay, so I have finally finished rendering this little salamander here. And while I was rendering, there were a few things that came up that I want to share with you guys. So the bullet and the chisel nibs are not actually marked. The only screening on here is pen art. Neither end actually says which is which. The chisel nib is towards the front of the body and the bullet nib is towards the back, which is the reverse of a lot of pins. So as I was working, I kept grabbing the wrong end because they feel exactly the same. The bullet end is a little bit mushy out of the box, which works okay for fills, but I know some people prefer a sharp bullet nib, and it was also hard to do smaller details like the eye of the salamander, and I just saw something that I'd like to go back into. So you'll have to quickly forgive me. These markers are not very responsive with either alcohol blender that I tried, which is the Blick Studio and the Prismacolor, and it didn't really respond well to rubbing alcohol either, which is unusual for a lot of most nicer alcohol markers like Prismacolor, Copic, even Blick Studio is much more responsive. When you spray, you'll get sort of that pushback blender effect, but it wasn't responsive to the blender either. And this was kind of a shame because I wanted to use the spritzed rubbing alcohol to sort of push some of those browns back and make it seem more like there were like highlights in the dirt, and that just really wasn't a possibility with the alcohol blender in this instance. So colors in general do not blend smoothly into each other. Even blends that you would think of as natural blends, like this sort of reddish orange with this carmine. Now carmine is a blue red, but it was the only red included, so it was what I had to work with. And as you guys saw in the video, I spent a lot of time working back and forth, so much time that it pushed a lot of marker through to the next page and even to the page after that. And usually with these marker tests, I don't get beyond the first page after getting ruined, and I usually leave that page in between to demonstrate bleed. So this was, in my opinion, a lot of bleed through considering how much blending I had to attempt. And you guys saw that I attempted blending not only using a blender marker but also color to color. So I would put down some orange and then do a lot of red, put down some red and then do a lot of orange on it, and I tried to work while the paper was still wet. That's one of the reasons why I like these uncoated heavier papers, is that they stay saturated longer. And even that wasn't really making much of a difference. Colors also blend unevenly, better in some areas, harsher in others. And this is exacerbated by the fact that one end is a chisel nib, and it's a fairly stiff chisel nib, so you can't get much nuance with that. The other end is a very small, albeit somewhat mushy, bullet nib. Brush nibs tend to be a lot better for these sort of blends. So it seems like no matter how much I saturated the paper, it's still the case. I still wasn't getting the sort of blends I was really hoping to get. And it's pretty much impossible to get a smooth blend, which is a shame considering this subject matter, which is a very smooth, shiny salamander, you know, that just wasn't gonna happen. And some colors are a little more reactive than others. Lemon yellow actually works fairly well as a blender for these markers. It's very, it makes the other colors react a whole lot. But the reds and the blues and the greens were not quite as reactive. So I'm going to finish this off and maybe salvage it a little bit with some white color pencil, some Signo white, and some white gouache. And those were not included, but you know, I do use them regularly, so I don't necessarily think there's anything wrong with doing that. And hopefully this will give some of you who are working with cheaper alcohol markers, trying to make those work, it'll give you guys some ideas on how to utilize inexpensive outside supplies to sort of get the effect you want. So I'm going to start with this white color pencil, and this is one of the whites from the Derwent Color Soft color pencils. They are some of my favorite color pencils because they are so soft, they'll even go down on these untextured or lightly textured papers. And I'm working kind of light because my goal is not to burnish the paper. My goal is just to get this sort of layer of shine down, which I'm going to then reinforce with the Signo and with the Copic Opaque White. And I tested this on yellow. So what is that? 300 series? Strathmore, yeah, 300 series Strathmore mixed media paper, which is what I use for all of my marker field tests. I do try to be consistent with what I'm testing on. It gives me a good gauge. This is an inexpensive consumer grade marker paper. It's a mixed media paper, so pretty much anybody can get access to this paper. I'm not really one for marker papers per se, because I do like to do a lot of layers, and a lot of those marker papers are just not really good for layering effects. And for those of you who enjoy using alcohol markers for stamping and for coloring for relaxation, this is a very thick or fairly thick paper. It's about cardstock weight or so, and I still had problems with these markers bleeding through due to my attempts at blending. So I have a feeling that these are just not really going to work too well for your coloring books, especially if your books have thinner pages. Also going back and adding a few white highlights to the dirt around this little salamander. Actually looks like a red eft. All right, so now that that's finished, I have a cup of clean water and a brush and my Copic Opaque White. So I'm going to go ahead and start adding some of those details as well. And they may resist a bit since I did just put down all that white color pencil. You may find it easier to use a white watercolor pencil like the Derwent Inktense, as it's less likely to cause a resist, but I'm not having too much trouble with resist right now. And if you're gentle and you get most of the paint out of your brush, you can also blend it a little bit. So if you're using some gouache, this would be a good technique. You can also pick up excess, but you're going to need a paper towel handy, and unfortunately I don't have one. So I'm just sort of blending it out a little bit into the body. All right, I'm gonna let this dry, and then I'm gonna reinforce some of those black spots just a little bit more, and then I think we can call this finished. All right, so finally, we're just going to go back in and add a little bit of the black that got knocked down. I may actually just grab the teal because I started these with teal, and then I darkened them into black. Because there isn't a gray, so teal is kind of the best thing I've got for reinforcing. And then we're going to take that white Signo and just pop a little bit of white highlight here and there to make this guy look a little more shiny. All right, so So my final verdict on these markers. First off, they are available on Amazon fairly cheaply right now. Let me just go ahead and bring that number up as a reminder. Because I can't always keep all those numbers in my head. They are $12.99 on Prime right now. So that means free shipping if you're a Prime member, and you're saving $17 off the list price. For $12.99, these are okay. You're paying a little bit more than a dollar a marker. And they are alcohol markers, but they're not really that compatible with the other blenders that I've used, which may mean there's going to be some compatibility problems if you're buying these to start your collection and then you purchase other markers afterwards. I have found that pretty much all of these markers that have been recently introduced don't necessarily have a whole lot to bring to the market. They're reusing the same body, the very common body type. They don't designate which end is the chisel, which end is the brush. I'm not even sure what these color families mean, because it doesn't seem like there's a whole line of these markers. So it's almost like the color families are there to give you the impression that there's more, but there isn't necessarily. Let me just double check on their website to make 100% sure before I tell you guys that. Oh, okay. So the parent company actually sells all kinds of stuff. A lot of it is like body care stuff. And they did contact me for this review, but the only thing I'm really seeing that's like art related are these 12-piece pen art twin tip drawing markers. So basically these color names don't mean a whole lot of anything, because there isn't an entire line of markers that they're drawing from. I can't get that to focus. And I can't help but wonder if maybe these are rebranded AliExpress markers, but that's just supposition and just wondering. If you are buying them at the $12.99 price, that is a good enough deal, because you're not paying for shipping, and you're gonna have to pay for shipping if you go through Ali. So if you think these seem okay to you and you like the sound of $12.99 plus free shipping, by all means, go ahead and order them. But I would really like to see more innovation from companies that are introducing alcohol markers on the market. We're getting a lot of the same kind of things, and we're not really seeing anything new or exciting or different. And that can get really tiring to review. So you can check the description below or my blog post for the links to these pen art markers on Amazon or on the parent website, Origini. And I hope you guys found this this review helpful and useful. I hope I maybe inspired you in some way, and I hope you enjoyed watching me illustrate this cute little salamander. I'm Becca Hilburn. Thank you guys so much for watching. If you like alcohol marker content, don't forget to check out my alcohol marker playlist. I have a lot of alcohol marker stuff in there. And when I say alcohol markers, I mean Copic, I mean Prismacolor, I mean Blick Studio brush markers, I mean markers like these, I mean markers from AliExpress. Pretty much anything that uses alcohol as the main solvent is going to be in that list. So I'll see you guys later. Bye guys!